What if we reimagined a healthcare system that was more human? What if we started asking, what happened to you versus what's wrong with you? California has plans for changing that conversation, and it starts with understanding adverse childhood experiences, or what we call an ACE. There are several categories of ACEs defined as abuse, neglect, and household dysfunction. Household dysfunction includes children whose parent or caregiver has been affected by substance abuse, incarceration, domestic abuse, mental illness, or a divorce. A large Kaiser Permanente and CDC-funded study found a significant link of increased early childhood adversity with poorer health and social well-being outcomes, such as greater risk of heart disease, diabetes, and obesity. In January of 2019, Governor Gavin Newsom appointed California's first Surgeon General, a Bay Area pediatrician by the name of Dr. Nadine Burke-Harris. Now, Dr. Burke-Harris has spent over a decade learning about ACEs and incorporating trauma-informed screenings into her practice. She is committed to educating health providers and communities about the effects of toxic stress. The initiative is called ACEs Aware and was formally launched January 1st, 2020. It has funding to give Medi-Cal providers training, clinical protocols, and payment for screening children and adults for ACEs. The goal here is to educate providers and families how a child's life may be impacted by prolonged exposure to stress. The solution is to create supportive care networks to help alleviate these family stressors. This could be connecting families to therapy, trauma-informed parenting classes, or addressing needs such as housing or food insecurity. The ACEs Aware initiative wants to reduce ACEs and toxic stress by half in one generation. This past year has revealed many traumas that have always existed in our society. The COVID-19 pandemic altered the lives of every person. In a matter of months, lives were lost to a virus we had fully yet to understand. Jobs were lost, schools were closed, family dynamics changed. Some parents began working from home as their children navigated online school. Many still needed to go to work as frontline service workers. We were asked to socially distance to slow the spread. We watched racial tensions unfold and social justice movements respond. We followed and reacted to one of the most polarized election years. Our home state was devastated by fires. We have seen a layering of trauma this year. If there was ever a time to explore how we could be more trauma-informed, it is now. If there was ever a time for more empathy in healthcare, it is now. So I ask, are you ACEs aware?